Who shot Stephanie Diskowski? It's a question Philadelphia cops believe has an answer, thanks to a report on Crime Watch Daily.
Sometimes you just need a break.
Absolutely.
That break came after Crime Watch Daily showed you this previously unseen video of Stephanie's suspected killer.
Sergeant, this was a big case for the Philadelphia PD. How was the Crime Watch Daily story helpful in pursuing a suspect?
Well, shortly after the airing of the program, the tip calls came pouring in, and eventually that led to an identification of the person of interest, which eventually led to the arrest of that person.
That person is 28-year-old James Jones. Cops had been looking for him for almost 2 years.
I believe Crime Watch Daily helped because of the fact that them airing that footage that has never been seen before, a lot of people gave in their tips on it.
Sean Sedonizak, Stephanie's live-in boyfriend, had just stepped out to the corner store. He ran down the street to get some milk. Just long enough, Philly police claim, for Jones to sneak up to the second floor apartment and shoot Stephanie in the head. Sean recalled the horrible night with our Michelle Sigona.
When you left, did you lock the door?
No, I did not.
You're gone for how long?
10 minutes tops. I got a phone call from a neighbor. He's saying that they heard a loud pop and someone ran out of my house.
When Sean returns to the house, Stephanie and the baby are not in the kitchen. He climbs the stairs to the bedroom and finds a strange sight, his 2-year-old daughter sitting alone on the bed. Stephanie is nowhere to be found.
When I walked to the end of the bed, she was just laying there. I went crazy.
Sean now believes Jones waited outside their apartment that night, then hurried inside to shoot Stephanie execution style right in front of their precious 2-year-old daughter.
Do you think your granddaughter witnessed her mother being shot?
Yes, I do.
In the surveillance footage, you can see a man coolly walking away from the scene of the crime. Identifying that man became an obsession for investigators. But the mystery is lifted after Jones, a vagrant, is arrested by Philadelphia police and charged with criminal homicide. And cops didn't have to go far to grab him. Jones was already serving time for an unrelated offense. And here's another shocker. Jones is no stranger to the family. He's someone who both Sean and Steven say they know from the neighborhood, and Stephanie knew him personally.
He was a friend at first because it was Stephanie's best friend's boyfriend. I even shook his hand.
He was at the rallies. He was at the funerals. Like, he tricked all of us. He had all of us believing that he actually cared, giving us a shoulder to cry on, sharing his condolences with us. And the man was just somebody who was sick in the head.
Cops won't talk motive, but some of the charges include murder, firearms violations, and robbery while inflicting serious bodily injury. Jones has not yet entered a plea on the murder rap. And Crime Watch Daily has learned Jones also has a long list of previous offenses for robbery and aggravated assault.
How often do shows like this help you as a homicide detective?
Well, airing of important video brings light to the situation, keeps it active, and sometimes people come along and, you know, will do the right thing. Courageously provide information to us.